most people, the interaction that they're going to have with a police officer is because if they're stopped for speeding or forgetting to turn their blinker on. There have been so many different interactions with police that have ended tragically. There was the arrest of Sandra Bland in Texas in 2015 that ended up with her dying in jail. There was the Minnesota stop with Philando Castile, where he was shot and killed. Those are really egregious incidents. What is the everyday person's interaction with police like, and do we have problems there?
Our project started a couple years ago when we requested state-level records from all 50 states on traffic stops.
When research is done on just one particular jurisdiction, one city, or even one state, it's hard to draw larger conclusions about the state of policing in the United States.
We find that Black and Hispanic drivers are ticketed, searched, and arrested at higher rates than white drivers, even after controlling for location, age, gender, and year. The pattern is widespread, occurring throughout the country. These differences highlight a disparity in police practices. In and of themselves, these statistics do not, however, indicate discrimination. To go beyond these disparities, we test directly for bias in search decisions. We try to directly infer the standard of evidence that officers apply when deciding to search.
So for example, if officers search white drivers if there's a 10% chance or greater that they're carrying contraband, but search black drivers if there's a 5% chance or greater, this is going to be measured as discrimination.
Based on our statistical analysis, we find that there's a double standard. Black and Hispanic drivers are searched on the basis of less evidence than white drivers. At the end of 2012, both Colorado and Washington legalized recreational marijuana.
Since black drivers were more likely to be charged with drug-related offenses prior to legalization, the policy change mitigated racial disparities.
What's interesting is that the number of searches also dramatically declined in both states. In part, this is because legalizing recreational marijuana removed a common reason for conducting searches.
The data comes to you in a different format from every state. We came up with a standard set of columns, like the race of the driver, gender of the driver, age of the driver, whether a search was conducted, whether contraband was found.
There are a number of states around the country that collect information when a police officer stops an individual, but that data is not analyzed.
To help researchers, journalists, and policymakers explore these issues, we're releasing all of our data and all of the code we use to analyze the data. In total, we're releasing records for over 100 million stops across 31 states.
And providing the training to journalists so that they can think more effectively about how to cover race and policing.
This is just a first step in a complex process of understanding and improving police contact with the public.